Yo, what's going on, Guardians? Mikowski here. Happy New Year. 2019 is about to come to a close, so I thought what better way to celebrate than by taking a look back at some of the epic, funny, and just clutch moments that have happened on the channel this year. Now, going into the end of the year, we're less than 100 subs away from 12K. And guys, this is crazy because we made the goal around Thanksgiving to hit 10,000 subs by the end of the year. And somehow you guys have carried the channel to almost 12. I don't really know how we got here. I don't know. I don't even know. It's like my third day. But I still thank you guys so much for all the support. It really feels like we're going into 2020 with a lot of momentum. I know that sounds cliche because it's like the new year or whatever, but I really feel it, dude. I really do. And that's all you guys, man. So I appreciate all the love and support. Without further ado, let's just get right into it and take a look back at some of the most epic moments from 2019. All right, so starting us off with this clip right here, I thought not only was this a great clip, but really more than anything, it was a great moment because it was the first time I got to play with my new sword teammates. And it was kind of surreal because the day before this, we had gotten recruited by Cruiser. And then the next day, we're in the same lobby. And I knew I wanted to pull something off. Something crazy, man. Something to prove that I had earned that spot. And that's right when this happens. Crazy, right? But yo, look in the feed. Pro then goes on to hit his own all headshot Slayer. Unreal. Like, I don't even, I still, like, watching this clip back, it's still crazy. And then the lights out. Slayer to lights out. What a way to have your first match go with your new teammates. Moving right along to the next moment, we've got our closer clip from our first montage to Soar. And this really was like the beginning for me, man, because up until this point, I didn't really ever try trick shots, right? And now I'm at the point where I'll throw it in a 5,500 comp match, right? So it's crazy looking back on it because I can really look at this moment now and see this is when we really started to try trick shots. Moving right along, it's the closer from Hire 2. Keep in mind, Hire 3 is being worked on as we speak. Hopefully we'll have that montage released in January. But for now, take a look back at the closer from our second montage with Soar. It's the beloved Kalat Slayer, and you might have missed it right there. That was indeed a collateral. We'll go back and slow it down for you. But dude, honestly, my favorite thing about this clip is the chair. Like, that's the coolest part of the clip, man. Screw the collab. But yo, let's take a look back at that. Hit the first shot in mid, look back towards red door, and luckily, both line up for the triple.
That guy with the long goodbye. Don't see him. Way too good.
Yep, a little too suspicious. He fucking no-scoped the shit out of me. Like that. Mikowski? Cheating fuckboy. I know you're a cheater, you fuck. I'm reporting the shit out of you too when this game's over. Ah, fuck, I'm gonna do it now. Fucking piece of
and
shit.
The actual webpage. That's actually how you get their attention. You report them in-game, that does really nothing.
Oh man, sorry. I had to lay out for that classic moment from this year. Now, I will go on to say that streamer and his community apologized, so I think we're all good. GG's all around. Now, moving on to this next clip, we have one of the most insane. I think this is one of the most insane clips I've ever hit. The quick flip three, like. I can't even speak and keep up with what's happening. Wait, what? Did you guys just see what happened? That was a seventh column annihilation. We wiped the whole team in sixes. Oh, man. Here's another look at it in case you blink.
Double down. Triple down. Look at them fall. You're unstoppable. Phenomenal. What? What? How? Seventh column.
I will never get tired of hearing Shax yell out 7th column. It's one of my favorite voice lines in the game, and that's exactly why in this next clip, we're getting another one with the sniper rifle. Get the bodies on that first guy. Unfortunate assist, but we do get the 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th. Pushing into spawn for the 6th and 7th. Now, this is actually... what? Like... I don't know if it would have changed. Obviously, there's nothing more than a 7th, and it kind of sucks that we missed that, but... I mean, it's a 7th column. We'll take it. Moving right along in the video, we've got a couple clutch 1v situations. This was actually a 1v6 and watch this work with the supremacy. And the rage for my teammate, but, you know, understandable. The connections, right? Oh, but oh my god! What? One more time for those in the back that may have missed it. Absolutely insane triple right there. And then the patience. Put the lights out. Now, we're not done yet. I can't lie. I thought the round was over. And it nearly screwed me up because I was not ready to continue playing. I really thought there was just four left. And I was already happy enough to hit that lights out. So I almost screwed myself here by just not being ready for the last two. But we do pull off the clutch headshot. And with one left, I'm just going to fast forward to the good stuff. The end result, which is a completion of the 1v6. GG's all around.
God damn.
And in similar Last Guardian standing fashion, we've got another 1v4 here on Countdown, setting the bomb to bait the opponents to push into market, and it works like a champ.
You got another one? Nice. I'm looking for the fourth.
The best part of this stuff has to be the teammates' reactions, right? That's always the most fun, man. Get me another
bomb. I'm clipping that from my view.
That's fine. Moving on to the next clip, we've got maybe the most epic Last Guardian Standing moment of the year. Here with my homie Kenny and Clutch, we are down one life in survival, so we've got to push through. The other team is just hiding in the back of the base, waiting out the end of the round, but we're not going to let that happen, right? I mean, we're in a pretty bad spot. This kind of sucks, but fortunately, I think it's Kenny or Clutch. One of these guys gets it. There it is. Boom. They get the pick to force OT. Only problem is that it's OT and we're all the way back in their spawn and they're already capping zone as I speak. Right now, they're already capping. So we're screwed, right? Capping zone. We're not going to get there in time. Defeat is almost certain. And then this happens. We got to get in there.
Yep.
One opponent
standing. All right, one of me left. He pushed me to specials.
Where's he going? Let's go! All lives Clutch is dead! Let's go! Moving on to our most recent memory, and it's the 1v3 controller and mouse and keyboard Clutch. And I really like this clip because in 2020, I aim to play more mouse and keyboard and get equally as proficient on both input devices.
2 seconds, 1 second, heavy's up.
The controller switched to mouse and keyboard Clutch. And in the finale spot, we've got this insane clip from Retribution. 15 kills in 45 seconds. Thank you guys so much for all the support on the YouTube this year. I know sometimes I wasn't the most consistent, but I've decided within myself that I want to make 2020 the year that we finally accomplish all these wild dreams that we've had in gaming since I was 15 years old. So expect more consistency, expect higher quality uploads, better edits, better everything. We are going all in this year, and I really have to just stop down and say a huge shout out and thanks to the homie Kenny Vaccaro, because he's the one who's really helping make a lot of this possible by helping put together this editing and graphic design team to help push me to reach these goals in 2020. So yo, huge shout out to the homie Kenny Vaccaro. Let's get right into this epic, nasty clip. And I believe it starts right here with the Dossie. And it's funny because I actually remember in this clip, I was so glad I wasn't running Spectral Blades because I knew people would discredit it and be like, do it without Spectral Blades. I don't really care as much about this stuff anymore because I've kind of taken the Ceridius approach where my thought is, okay, well, you put on whatever I use and try to do the same thing, right? Not the cleanest way to start off the clip with the double bodies from the Supremacy, but hey, bodies are snipes too, and we push up. There's the headshot on the triple. Looking for the fourth. We hit it on the sniper challenging as well. And I don't know how this... How is that not a Slayer? I don't know. Maybe this could have even been a Reaper, and we could have kept chaining. Nonetheless, it's the lights out into the lights out. But wait, we're not done yet. That's not just the lights out. We're going to hit the Reaper. But wait again. Did you guys see what happened there? Here, let me rewind it. All right, so if you slow it down, it's really hard to see in real time, but we sniped this dude's grenade before continuing the clip. What the absolutely nutty Reaper, especially when coming off the team wipe just before that. So it's a back-to-back team wipe going from spawn to spawn, getting 6 kills each time. That's insane. And then we top it off with the no scope, quick scope, triple kill. Now, I just missed that so you guys knew I didn't have aimbot, okay? All right, I'm just kidding. I choked, all right? I'm sorry. Thank you guys all for an amazing 2019. I never would have thought this would have happened to the YouTube or Twitch channel this year, but it did, and that's all because of you guys. So thank you so much for all the support. Have a safe and happy new year this evening. Thank you again so much. I really cannot say it enough. And as always, guys, stay positive, keep sniping, and we'll see you in 2020, Guardians.